perhaps maybe there is not, will go back not necessarily to the artist, but to the community that sustains such works or similar works, or takes care of them, or preserves them. So,
shops that are like hubs for this, at the city level or district level, we call them districts of solidarity economy, and it's not just food, it's also clothes, it's also, we have groups of buying energy, renewable energy plants together, or contracting different services, and it's growing very quickly. So the whole idea is to change the economy by practice, by our everyday life, and doing it as a community. And Solidarius Italy is part of Solidarius International, and Euclides is the founder of Solidarius in Brazil.
I'm Euclides Mance, live in Brazil. I have an history with solidarity economy. 20 years reflecting with the people about their needs, their solutions, their problems, with the popular education view. In this view, the knowledge is elaborate together in dialogue. Each person have your history and your knowledge, then about these practices, reflecting these practices together, we build solutions. Then I learned a lot of the people. I learned a lot. Each situation, each culture, different solutions. By other side, I receive this knowledge, is responsible, mine responsible, restitute this to society. Then I write texts, books, and other, by other ways, contributing to organize different solidarity economy initiatives. Then, by this way, I am here. I was invited to contribute in this moment to reflection about Greek reality, particularly about solidarity economy, networks. In the past, I worked into government Lula, in the first government, Zero Hunger Program. After this, contribute also in other program about agrarian development, Latin American. I also traveled at several countries, Ecuador, Venezuela, and Cuba, and other countries. In this dialogue, sometimes with government, and other times with the cooperatives, popular initiatives, but by this way, constructed, build other world, a good world, more freedom for all persons. In Portuguese, we have a word as bem viver, well living. It's for us an important concept, but it's one approach about our lives. Yes. I end this moment because this is a presentation.
Εγώ θα χρειαζόμουν κάποια μετάφραση.
Ναι, να σου κάνω εγώ.
Όχι, όχι αυτά. Αυτά τα καταλαβαίνω. Μετά όταν θα μπούμε στο διάλογο.
Οκ. Okay.
Thank you.
Να, άμα θέλουμε, ναι.
Πώς θα κλείσουμε,
Πέτρο. Present ourselves too, ναι.
Yeah.
Έρωνα. Πέτρο, αρχίμερες.
Εγώ πάμε Ιταλιάνος.
Σαν είπα για
Yes, but we don't understand.
No parla italiano.
Εσύ, αλλά, σε πρόσωπο, μπορεί να δείτε. Partendo qui, l'assemblea che sta durando adesso, come una persona che mi interessa molto la... tutti parliamo di cambiare la società, cioè, in un altro modo che possiamo dire significa un cambiamento attraverso la società, attraverso la cultura, attraverso l'espressione. L'arte è sempre good, comune, prodotto, non lo dico proprio. Credo che questa assemblea qui è veramente una...
Έτσι κι αλλιώς είναι στα ιταλικά, οπότε δεν καταλαβαίνουμε και την πόρα.
Πρέπει να διαβάσεις. It's difficult for me to translate from Italian to you can translate English what you said. You are Greek.
Θες να πω τι είπα. Όχι. Εγώ είπα ότι ανήκω εδώ σαν ένα μέλος που με ενδιαφέρει πάρα πολύ για μια αλλαγή η οποία γίνεται μέσα από το κοινό αγαθό της τέχνης. Και είναι ένα εγχείρημα το οποίο αφορά περισσότερο στη παραγωγή καλλιτεχνικού προϊόντος παρά οποιαδήποτε άλλο.
Πίσω από Μαρία Λουίζα. Όχι.
Το όνομά μας και μια ιδιότητα, μωρέ, δεν χρειάζεται.
Να ναι, ρε παιδιά, δεν χρειάζεται λόγο.
Θωμάς. Ηλία, μετάφρασε.
Θωμάς.
Ηλία, μετάφρασε.
Ο Θωμάς.
Ανιματέρ καλλιτεχνικών και πολιτισμικών διαδικασίων.
Animator of artistic and
cultural
activity.
My name is Christina and I'm an artist and I've been participating in this occupation for 4 years now. Thank you for coming.
Well, me, I told you before, okay?
Who are you?
Who are you?
Artist and participant of the Open Assembly of Embros. The same?
Anna? Artist, participants. Let's move it on.
Your name?
Anna.
Anna.
We have some guys there.
Stefanos. Let's say the same. I dominate. Like to learn about
more and more that it's so involving and so interesting that I could change and make the rest of the side activity happen. But so that economy is about relationships and about recreating a community and a society that puts people at the center. And is conscious of its impact, of our impact, in our everyday action, without being moralistic or ideological in this, but simply wanting the buen vivir for all, and not just for myself. So that's the perspective in which we try to reorganize, rethink how, starting from our local level, but then networking at different levels, we can practice a different life and not just have a utopian idea of it, of how it should be. And as Euclides said, every person, every culture, every country has a different way, a different approach and the different moment in which these things emerge. But the important thing is that these are not these are self-managed and popular ways of changing the economy. They're not policies coming from any kind of government, good or bad. Though we can and we should influence our governments at all levels to go away from the market economy, which is destroying us at all in many different ways, and embrace the true way in which people can cultivate their relationships. And as I like to say, our currency in the economy, since we're called solidarity economy, is trust. It's not money.
Can I ask something? Mm-hmm. On Friday, I was...
How many people were there on Friday? So we get an idea.
Me, Anna, Andrea, mm-hmm. I know you weren't. Nico, you were? No.
So us two, I guess. So anyway, I had some American friends, comrades, that came yesterday, and I was talking about the alternative economy and all that, fighting against them with. And we discussed it for a couple of hours. And I remember in your presentation that you show us a cart. And this is a cart that's like a currency, quote unquote, and people within a production line are using this also, not within this one line, but also in association to other products or other services. And the question that I can answer is actually how one or a community gets this cart in a way. Mm-hmm. What does it represent? I don't know what it represents, but what is the initial way mm-hmm. of issue mm-hmm. these cards? And I realized that was a question of mine as well, and I didn't have an answer. So I'm posing the question right now, and it might give something to talk about.
Okay. I believe it's good to explain before answer your question, because other persons situate into the subject. Solidarity economy is a new form of organize our consumption, our interchange of products, knowledge, our financial action, our technological development, our production. Then is another way. This way have ethical principles.
We got one.
Ethical principles, but also ecological principles and economic principles, because need be sustainable. Okay. When one person can work and produce cultural products or tangible products, okay, other person can use or recycle this product to attend, to fulfill their need. But into capitalist interchange system, the person need one signs of value to make this interchange, okay? This sign of value is money. If the person have money, give money and receive this product. Receive this product. If the person don't have money in the market, can't solve their needs, okay? In solidarity economy, we have lot of needs to attend. But we have also producer capacities, okay? But if we don't have this sign of value, how organize this interchange, okay? Well, in solidarity economy, we can issue these signs of values. There is several ways to issue these signs of values. Sometimes it's named social money, and other places is credits, solidarity credits, and other places is other names, okay? But I explain here three ways to make this, and after dialogue about the card, okay?
Right.
The first way is the simple, is efficiently, but is we need use carefully this way. For example, we have 15 families or participants of this community, okay? Well, we have products, we have needs, but we don't have money. Then we issue one amount of this money. We create this social money, establish the value of this social money, for example, one euro, and generate this and made the distribution of this social money in the same amount to each participant, okay? Then we have 100 social money in my hand. With this social money, I can pay to other products or services offered into our circuit, okay? I have two main responsibilities with this social money. The first, if I go out of this group, I need restitute,
give back
this money that I receive at the start of this group, okay? If I was received 100, I need give back 100. The other responsible is use this value of science to promote the behavior well-living of the persons. Not use this to exploit someone, or use this to unfair price, or use this by other things, okay? It's very good, very, very good, because the people can, in their house, made several kinds of products and offer in this community and receive any these credits, use these credits to other products, but not only products, services also, not only goods, but services also. Then we, the part of our needs, the persons present to community, I need this, okay. I can offer this, okay. We made a
matching.
Yes, matching. And if I need the services, okay. Oh, I call, I need this product, okay, it's possible. I pay with this social money, okay? And this social money remain in this community because it's accepted by this community, okay? It's the first way. We have one problem with this way. If I need raw materials, I need other tools or other things, I need to buy with euro, not social money. How solve this problem? Okay. It's possible, says to community, I need this raw material. Someone can acquire this raw material and give and trazer and come to our group this product, I can pay with social money, okay? This is one solution. But is not a good solution. Okay?
Yeah, but because we involve money.
Not because involve money, because perhaps the people don't have money.
But that's okay. What I'm saying. If you need tools and yes. The community doesn't have the tools, then you have to go outside the community. And if there's no other community with social money that has the tools, then you involve with someone that has money to buy the tools.
The way the social money go out from the community.
It could be. But the solidarity money remains in the community.
Right.
This is interesting because one thing is value flow, another thing is money flow. It's different. For example, in this case, the person was working, receive credits, and after need a tool, okay? Then other person have ill, acquire this tool, and offer this tool in this circuit, okay? This person offer these credits, okay? And receive these tools. But in fact, the euro goes out, but the euro that goes out represents the value produced by this person, okay, that which offer this social credits in this circuit. It's complex, I understand, but after we can talk more about this, okay? But it's a good solution because if we don't have money, we have conditions to issue money, but it's we need understand this issue, the amount of money issued need be related our capacity to produce. Because if I have capacity to produce in 1 month 200, okay, I don't receive at the beginning 2,000, because if I receive 2,000, after how restitute to community 2,000 in produce areas, okay? Then we need be responsible in this issue, okay? It's the first methodology. It's very good, but there is some problem. The second is different. We organize, for example, one group to acquire products that we need mostly. Rice, coffee, sugar, and other things, okay? If one family acquire 500 euro, 10 family acquire 5,000 euro. When I acquire together 5,000 euro in these products, we obtain a discount. For example, 10%. Okay. 5,000, 10%. 500 euro, okay? This 500 euro is put into our fund. Each person receive social money corresponding their participation in this buy, okay? Then we have money in this fund. We have the products monthly acquired by us, okay? But I have also social money. With this social money, we can use to our transactions among us, but we have money here to make microcredits or acquire tools, machines, and other things, okay? If not 10 families, but 100 families, don't $500, but 500 euros, but 5,000 euros into this fund each month. This is very interesting. With this fund, we can organize a community bank. This community bank operates by self-managed way. The people are owner of this money, not the government, not the bank institution. It's the community. And the community manage this bank by their needs. Okay, this is very important. How much money in this fund? How much credit is in circulation? There is a third way to generate the social money. The third way is if we have a local shop, the people can offer in this shop their products. For example, farmer products or services also in this shop. Okay, I put in this shop these products. Okay, how much is the value of this? Okay, then the value is charged in my card. Okay, then I have these credits in my card. These credits I can spend not only in this shop, but in other shops connected into network with this shop. Then I can offer Portuguese lessons or English lessons, okay? One person or theater lessons or psychological services or health services or what attend fulfill the need of the person in this circuit. Other people receive this product and I receive the credits. And with these credits, I pay by other services. I pay by other products, okay? It's the three ways to use this value signs, self-managed by our communities. It is very important because the capitalist market work with scarce money. The money need be scarce because if don't be scarce, don't have value. If the money is as air, okay, the money don't have value. Then we don't have money to our interchange because the money is scarce. The empowered corporations, banks concentrated this money. The capitalist way of production don't share the value produced because there is a surplus accumulated. The people don't receive money in amount adequate to fulfill their needs. At final, the people need credits. But in the capitalist system, to receive credit, we need offer one property, our private property, our house, our car, our other things, okay? But at final of this process, the people don't arrive to pay this credit. At final offer, okay, it's my house to bank other people, okay, my house to bank. In this moment, there is lot of house. The bank need sell this house, but the people don't have money. this house depreciated into market, and at final is not possible solve these credits. But in this moment, the capitalist way is the banks, in most important institution in our economy, because economic flows depend on flows of money. Then our government need solve this problem and give money to the bank. Money before to health, to education, to solve our needs in this moment to banks. Okay? The capitalist way is not solidarity economy way. In our economic solidarity system, we need generate our signs of value, not only self-managed enterprise, not only democracy participation to produce goods and services, but democratic participation and self-managed way to issues our value signs, control our value signs and eliminate our value signs, because the community is the central point, not the money or value signs. Okay.
And how the network can guarantee the sustainability and the security of such a value circulating system? How you can guarantee that, for instance, the social money cannot be falsified?
Okay, there is several ways also. No? One simple way is printed this money into fotocopiadora, photocopies. Okay. But on the other side, the people signs this.
Photocopy?
Signs this photocopy, okay? Then there is all people sign this, then circulating into our circuit. But how we connect, nós conhecemos nós.
How do we know?
The other person, okay? It's impossible when people arrive here if I don't know these people. Well, they have social money, okay, but the signs is not correspond to the signs of our group. I'm sorry, but this is how you receive this money. Who pay you with this money, okay? Because we have the control. This is simple. The community banks. It's a small group.
Okay, it works with a small group.
Yeah, but in Brazil we have the social money circulating into large communities, okay? Circulating into normal shops, mm-hmm. Okay? In this case, there is aspects of the printed this money, security elements, or other security elements to this
watermarks.
Yes. Like the real money.
Like the
money.
Is the ticket to theater or other football games is a security process to emission. But not falsify this, okay? It's very complicated to falsify these tickets. Then in Brazil, there is one place to print this social money. Our network have now 105 community banks. Each bank, each money, printed in only one graphics printer. printer.
No,
but
yes, famous.
Okay, there are other two ways to solve this. Okay, another is the card. This card is electronic process. There is the devices to use this card. Only these devices can generate this point into these cards, because there is there is a mathematical algorithm is generated by cryptographic way. It's impossible generate these points in other devices. These devices are in these shops, okay?
They participate in shops.
Yes, then we have control about these devices and the software, and then it's impossible falsificate these points. The other is the using smartphones. Using the smartphone, you access your account, then you can transfer credits to other person or receive credits of other person, but these transactions can be viewed by all persons. Mm-hmm. Okay, mm-hmm. If you acquire here one coffee and pay with the system, all community know about this
transaction.
If one person have a lot of credits in his account, other trustability, each transaction, okay, it's offer this lesson about guitar or other things, then by this way, this person have this credits.
Open data accessible to anyone.
This technology today, there is several groups offering this technology, but not only into solidarity economy. There is several capitalistic groups offering this technology. Mm-hmm. If you want to organize a barter system, okay, there is an enterprise offering this technology. Mm-hmm. To organize this group, managing this with security, okay? But in solidarity economy also, we have technological tools to this. In Solidarius, our network, we have one tool to this. International transactions, also local transactions, okay? But we don't need use this technology. We use this technology if we need it. But if we don't need, okay, we print into a photocopy, okay, and sign, okay, it's good to us. But if we need interchange with other groups, okay, then the graphic is social money and circulating into this territory, okay. If we need change products and services with people of the other country, okay, using the electronic process. But the most important is not the technological solution. The most important is an ethic way in the use of this technology. The technology, okay? Mm-hmm. Because it's not the social money or credits or no. Is the community, is the person, is the ethical principles, the central element to, in fact, organize a solidarity economy.
Yes, I want to ask if you think this...
Συγγνώμη, sorry. Επειδή τα ελληνικά μου είναι τώρα χάλια, θα μπορούσε κάποιος να το μεταφράζει στα ελληνικά, να καταλάβω.
Όλο είναι δύσκολο, γιατί είναι πάρα πολλά. Αυτό
ναι, το κατάλαβα λίγο ως πολύ.
Μπορώ να κάνω, να σου το πω μετά,
ναι,
σε σχέση και με το, γι' αυτό τα ηχογραφώ.
Ναι, εντάξει.
Κράτησε το κωδικό ηθικό, ηθική.
Yeah,
το point είναι αυτό, το
έτοιμο. Θα μάθατε να σου και κάποια πραγματάκια να στα λέω.
Όχι, όχι, όχι. Λίγος πολύ κατάλαβα.
Issues about translation.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Just in case what you were wondering, what was the whole break discussion?
Okay.
I was if you think this economy could grow.
Can μπορείς να το λες λίγο πιο δυνατά για να γραφτεί.
Do you think that this economy could grow more and more and then change capitalism, or it could work close next to it? Because as I've read, all the times that these networks grew more, the system stopped them. Like the capitalist system created problems for them, and then they were disappeared. How do you think?
It's a very interesting question. In the past, the social economy, the cooperatives, was developed into high level, more high level. Today, we have social cooperatives, or social, but cooperatives, okay, managed by workers, moving millions of euros. Then don't change the system, the economic system, because remain in the same interchange system, the market. The cooperatives have products, but the people don't have money, then don't sell this product, okay? Sell products for other persons which have money. Then don't change the economic system. Solidarity economy, this interchange, local interchange system, develop one new strategy. This new strategy is not only about self-managed enterprise, but build another interchange system, because this generated this same values. Okay, but this science value or value science need be under control of this community, because this the strategy is organized local economic circuits. The people organize the mapping about their needs, about their products. Needs that we don't solve in our circuit, we need by outside. But these circuits are put into network system. The circuit connected with other in one country, several countries around the world. When we have in this circuit one product, one good or services offered here, but this product is needed in other circuit, okay, we can offer this product goes out to other circuit. In this moment we need the value science, okay? How organize this group here have their science, but we have one value science to make this compensation among these several groups. This value science is related with our funds, with money in this fund. Okay, if I have local money, my local money is converted into this. Science universal sign. This universal sign is sent to another group. Another group receives this and generate in this group another value science in this group, okay? And send the product to other group, okay? Well, if this strategy growing, what happened? What happened? More money are in our funds because more needs are solved into our system. The person, the plans, the consumption plans of the persons, the person paid one part with credits, other part with euro, more euro in the funds. We acquire outside, but the margin, our funds. At the moment, we change the euro, real, dollar, other money to this other value sign, okay? For us, it's very good, but this is converted into other capitalist system, mm-hmm. or no? If this fund is self-managed by this community, if we have control about this issue of the sign and elimination of the sign, our community have sovereignty, economic sovereignty about their production, consumption, interchange, okay? It's a new economic system sustained by communities, but not only territorial communities. The community of one street, but also this territorial, unterritorialized communities, okay? Perhaps one community of artists of the Greece, several parts of the Greece integrated into one community, interchange among them values to organize their activities, okay? Offering into different communities their activities, services, and receiving in these communities some part in euro, other part in credits, but integrated into this network, in cooperation between all, solving our needs, sustaining our activities, okay? By this way, it is possible to superate the capitalist system. If it will occur or not occur, doesn't depend about our technology. It depends about our ethic way of life, our principles. The person is not a thing, because this, the person is the our life is not. Our needs can't be solved into market. Our need of friends, love, and careful, okay? It's not possible solve our human needs into market. Some economic needs are solved in market, but the products in capitalist markets was generated, exploiting the people, damaging the environment. When we use our money to buy these products, we accomplish somos coniventes.
You are co-responsible.
Co-responsible with this, that exploitment, that the environmental damaging, because our money will be used to, in the same way, exploiting the people, damaging the ecosystem. When we use our money into solidarity economy circuits, we can contribute to construct, to build another economic system. I don't know if I respond to your question, but I believe it.
Yes, I think the important thing was the ethical part. That's to protect the system, the people need to be very involved and have some issues.
By this, we need education, yes. We need information, we need not only mental interpretants, but especially emotional interpretants, energetic activity interpretants, okay? It's important because the ethics doesn't work about ideas. The ethics work connecting ideas with our feelings, with our actions. If one people is suffering, what we can do to transform this reality? Solidarity economy is three levels of solidarity economy. One level is survival economy, and food, work, okay, survival level. At second stage is a resistance level. Survive, but against the system, not contributing to maintain this unjust structures, okay? But the third level is the economic liberation level, is a true liberation process, not only against the capitalist system, but in fact building a new economic system with our economic actions, consumption, production, trade, finance, etc.
I would like to add two things. The first is that in order not to be captured by the market system, the free market system, which as we know is free for some and not for others, there's one important element there are two important elements to consider. The first one is that if the community that uses these means keeps control of them through self-management, trust relationships, and is sufficiently small so that this kind of control is participatory, then it's very difficult that it's captured. But we want this to expand. We want this to become hegemonic in a sense. So it can't be tiny little isolated groups. They need to network together. And how you network is also very important, because you can network in a centralized way, or you can network in a distributed way. And when you network in a distributed way, if one part collapses, the rest of the network remains. It's like in computers and communication and internet, for instance. Although actually internet is not, it's quite centralized. But, so it's not a good
example. It's like, let's say, Linux and Windows.
Exactly. but the other concept is the concept of growth. So we want expansion and networking, but growth is something that is quite different from what we tend in the market economy. When you when an initiative grows to a level in which the participatory processes and the self-management is no longer sustainable, that's its limit. And therefore, the only thing it can do is to help generate another initiative, another network, another circuit, another production unit, another part, and collaborate with it, not in competition, but in collaboration with it. And that will fulfill other needs that there are in the community. So if you grow by multiplying, you don't get these centralized accumulating power structures that can destroy the rest of the networks.
How do you know when it reached the stage? What are the marks?
How do you know?
When how do reaches, you know that the system is that?
There's no recipe. I mean, it's
there are no symptoms.
Huh?
There are no symptoms.
There no, symptoms there are. There's no common, I mean, there's no guideline that says, okay, 1, 2, 3, and if these...
No, but I mean it's the assembly that realizes it and then they decide that they should take it to the next level? Or?
Well, the ways in which these things are organized are very different as well. So, in some instances there are forms of assemblies, in others there are not. There's a lot of, as technologies have evolved, there's a lot of electronic communication going on, and decision making also passes through these. Some are more organized, some are less organized. So, as we are still in an initial, well, not so initial, in certain parts of the world it's more developed, but in other parts, as in Europe, it's still, we have a long history of mutualism, of cooperation, of movements, of social movements, etc. But the reorganization in this mode, we don't really much.
But let's say it would start looking as capitalist, and then you know that you have
yes.
to move on.
Yes. When a structure in a cooperative, for instance, becomes too similar to a structure in a normal business, and you have a board of directors, and you have the workers who don't participate in the decision-making process, etc., that's a symptom.
Okay.
That it's not working.
When you reach this level of somehow we are starting to not cooperate but to
compete
with one another, how something rotten started to develop?
Conflict exists also in South American economy, but it's how you look and how you address conflict that makes the difference. As probably you know well, if you have assemblies and groups, etc. So to keep a participatory and democratic process going, and also enterprises. Because to do something not just at an artisanal level, but something that can generate employment and generate a living condition is something that has to be organized at a certain level. So it's the balance between keeping the advantage of being part of a circuit network, because in this you have you give and receive continuously, and supposedly there's no accumulation because it's not an advantage to accumulate something that you cannot then spend outside, for instance. So to accumulate social money doesn't make much sense.
How to spend it inside your circuit?
You can only spend it inside your circuit. And so there are some mechanisms of this sort that help prevent, mm-hmm. but there's no solution that can. You have to solve any micro conflict in order that it doesn't become a huge problem. If there's personality things, etc., you create two separate circuits and try to see if there's possibility of collaborations between some. But the important thing is that the true nature of these groups, the participation, the democracy, the non-exploitative work, etc., are at the core.
About other aspect of the growing, the capitalist grows is destructing our planet because it's insustainable. For example, the lamp. Each year we need change because the lamp broke.
It's obsolescent.
Then solidarity economy, the growth of a solidarity economy needs to change this technology by other one lamp during 100 years or 1,000 years. Okay? Then we solve one problem, light, and we don't need produce another lamp another year, okay? Because we have a capitalist way is not by this way, because they need sell lamp, not fulfill our need of light. Then we need liberate the productive forces of this market system, because the development of productive forces in capitalist way aims obtain more surplus, more profit. Okay, for us it's diverse, because our goal is fulfill the needs of well living, of bem viver, into our community, not make more profit. Because this, we need to change this technology by other ecological, sustainable, economic, and solidarity sustainable. This is very important, because if we change the technological process using not scarce materials, but ecological materials, recycling, or renewable raws, we can expand the production of goods and services to attend the need of all people around the world, arriving in this stage of technological development, assuring a well-living to all without destructing our planet, okay? By a smart technological way, okay? This is important to idea about growing our economic system.
But what about ownership of this system?
It's a very interesting question. It's very interesting because It's the same question, in fact, by other aspect. For example, if we have some cell phones, okay, but it's scarce. There is a lot of people that need this, but it's scarce. How solve the problem about property of this? In the past, someone said, this not private property is public property. By this way, this cell phones now is the all people of Greece, okay? But in fact, this cell phone is scarce. The most part of the people in Greece can't use this because we don't have an amount for attend the needs of all people, okay? Then, political statization of the goods to solve the private property don't solve our problem. Our problem is the people have needs to attempt to fulfill. Then, how is the way to solve this problem? The way is produce cell phone in amount sufficiently to attend all people. When we have a cell phone to attend the necessity, the needs of all people have one property to attend their needs. I don't need the property of the other person because I have. And if we liberate the productive forces, we have condition to fulfill the needs of all people. By this way, the privation of property disappears. The privation of property. Because the people have the property to fulfill their needs, okay? It's a way to solve this problem and the public and private freedom, okay? Because in this moment, because the public freedom is result of the individual freedom. But the individual freedom need a public freedom because doesn't exist one person without community. Doesn't exist community if doesn't exist the person. The person and the community are the same reality. And I develop one minute more this idea. I need think, but how I think? I need a language to think, but the language that I use to think is not produced by me. It's produced by community, okay? I need a community. If it's without community, I don't have language. If I don't have language, I don't think. I don't, because this, my education need the other person. Because the science are collectively production. If I need think and education to my freedom, I can't liberate myself if I don't be connected into a community. No one liberates no one. Nobody liberates nobody. Nobody liberates itself. The people liberates together among them into a community, okay? No one educates no one, no one educates himself. The person educates into community, connected into community. Because this don't exist my private property or public property because don't exist the personal, one person, without exist the community, without exist the community. If this is the person, my personal freedom requires the public freedom. The public freedom requires my personal freedom. By this way, the properties, all properties, my properties, public properties, need be used to promote the freedom of each person of all communities, okay? By this way, this property need cumprir, need realize, make ethical principles of assure the freedom of all. I can't use the property only to my freedom. If the property does not exist to attend all, we need organize our use of this property to well-living of all. But if it's possible produce more properties to fulfill the need of all people, when we shall produce to attend the need of all people, okay? This is a concept integrating the subject of property, respect our freedom. But not subjectivistic freedom, because this subjectivistic freedom is abstraction. It's abstraction. The real freedom is the freedom we live because we make part of one community.
May I ask something? Well, it's a little bit like becoming the advocate of the devil now. The traditional rhetoric of capitalism is that if we disconnect production forces from scarcity and copyrights, we diminuate competition. If we diminuate competition, then we do not have, according always to the capitalistic rhetoric, we do not have progress. For instance, if we didn't have the Second World War, we wouldn't have Boeing and Airbuses today, and other, or even internet, that came out from the DARPA military system. Okay. Do you think that this rhetoric corresponds to something, to a reality, or we can have production, social production, ethical forces, labor, that can go on and be creative as much and maybe better than what we experience into the capitalistic environment.
In solidarity economy, the needs are understand not an opportunity to obtain more profit. The needs are understanding by other way. Our needs make part of our life. So our needs can be also a pleasure for us. Develop forms to fulfill our needs is develop our humanity. Okay? We can talk with some words, but we can organize this word in the talk to not only communicate one thing, but have pleasure in this communication. Okay? The same is all other needs we have. The capitalistic ways develop our needs to make more profit. By this way, there is the competition among the enterprises attending fulfill needs the people that have money, and but directing this, driving these needs to another way, not in fact a human way, but alienated consumption. The people imagine obtain status, or if you want a good husband, use this product, or you want a beautiful girlfriend, use this shirt or this no sei que. It's an alienation of our feelings, our in solidarity economy is totally different of this. Important is the person, okay? Then when we produce imagining the other people. How I can attend the need of the other person, but developing our needs to fulfill more human way, okay? It's different. It's different. By this way, not competition to among the enterprises to profit, but I can solve your need by this way. Other can solve by other way, okay? But we not in competition to money. We are developing our culture, developing art, developing science, developing technology, developing the satisfaction our needs, okay? In solidarity economy, when we organize our funds, we have criteria to use this fund. For example, supporting one enterprise, but this enterprise have their sustainable plan. The sustainable plan defines the received in this enterprise in this amount of money to sustain, okay? Our community acquire product of this enterprise is maintained. The surplus used to give products or develop new technologies or other activities, okay? But if we need more products than capacity of this enterprise produce, what we do? We create another cooperative, another enterprise. Not this growing. Not a second, a third, a fourth, new technology, okay? Perhaps this technology is obsolete, then not use more this technology because it's not ecologically friendly, okay? Not a problem. The person that work in this enterprise will be integrated in the new enterprise, okay? Not competition enterprise, but our needs is the center of this other economy, but not satisfied by market, satisfied by our solidarity circuit, okay? Under our control, not under the control of financial market.
For a community, is it better to use communication to use the internet or use other ways or combination?
The communication is all ways, no? For some purposes, internet is better. For other, no. The face-to-face is very important because the communication is not only one image, is not only one idea. No? It's a human presence. is in Brazil we have this hugs, no? The hug is a very important thing in our life, hug the people, no? It's because it's the body, okay? This is very important. This is feeling, this is our life. It's a hurt, okay? This
oralidade humana.
It's very important. It's personal communication.
There, when one hears the word solidarity, just the word solidarity, what do you think? What connotation do you give it? Because this is very cultural, it depends on how it has developed in each country. So.
There are many forms of solidarity. There is no one solidarity. It's always in plural.
Mm-hmm.
We should talk about solidarities, mm-hmm. not solidarity.
Mm-hmm. And in fact, many times we talk about solidarity economies because there are many different approaches. But any other?
For us that have a Greek language, a smaller language, we translate solidarity as allegie. The word itself means that it's actually a very old word coming from ancient Greek and means that each citizen guarantees the other citizen.
Citizen?
Yes. That's where that thing developed in the city. We talk about a time that there were no human rights or things like that. We had free citizens or others, but they were not free citizens. They had a king, they had something like that. So free citizens were guaranteed also at the economic level, the other citizen.
Among each other.
Yes. That means that you have to have an assembly, demos. You have to be autonomous, that means creating your own laws. And in that way, each citizen was guaranteeing the other citizens. Your money was valid, for example, Athens was receiving its own money, and this money was valid not because it had the stamp of an important king, but because the citizens were accepting that and they were guaranteeing that.
Mm-hmm.
That's the general idea. For me, it has a very wide meaning because you can guarantee for other peoples a lot of things. I don't know if I'm answering
to your question. I think what you say is also very important because it comes to the origins of democracy.
Yes.
The Athenian democracy. Why the Greeks, Athenians, invented the democracy? Out of a necessity. At this period, Athens was not like today, of course. And there were different vimi communities dispersed all around the area, some of them situated far enough to the measures of the period. Eh?
Mm-hmm.
And what they were experiencing, these communities that they were out of the center, were the raids of some servants of the oligarchs, that they were behaving as robbers. They were going, for instance, to Demos Acharnon, that was situated somewhere toward the Northern Mountain, and they were taking all the production.
Okay,
not Acharnon, Acharnis.
Acharnis, over there.
Where is Nord?
It's okay.
Well, it's north west.
Acharnis,
okay. they started to create a kind of mutual solidarity, actually, to guarantee their production. And they called that the assembly of the demos, because if the middle class of the period, if we can call it middle class, okay, couldn't defend their own products, agricultural or husbandry products, they will disappear, vanish. So they created this solidarity that guarantees the existence of the other or the other, and through this process they started to elaborate some ideas of turning this mutuality into something solid. And then the most intelligent among them, or the most maybe not intelligent but the most up to, sat down and wrote some basic rules that through time took the form of what used to be called democracy at the period. So solidarity and democracy goes together. You cannot separate one from the other. You cannot have solidarity in an oligarchic only as a form maybe of resistance, but not functioning. Fully function.
No, this is actually great because, and it adds some things that I hadn't thought of. Because yesterday when we were discussing with some of the Solidarity initiatives on how to create a network, the issue of common values and common goals, of course, as in any kind of common initiative were brought out, but the main issue is having a common pact among all of those who participate. And it's this pact, this alliance, in a sense, that it's a mutualistic form of alliance, that is what holds the solidarity economy network in that kind, in that sense. What I expected to hear, and fortunately I did hear, is negative connotations of solidarity, because what solidarity economy is not, it's not charity. It's not something that you do towards someone else because they're on a lower level. It's always a relationship of mutual help. The help element exists also, but it's not in a way that you are helping someone else because of
philanthropy.
As philanthropy. And I wanted to add to the point what you said about putting the whole vision about the property issues, because today we can distinguish between immaterial and material, or tangible products. And it's easier to conceive intangible products as something common, as a commons, intellectual production and things like that. But still, if we think of it in a way in which you're only looking at the individual freedom of the use of that intangible product, then you may abuse of the freedom of who produced it. For instance, take a book. I put a lot of work, energy, relations, etc. in creating a work, and I free it in as a public domain. Anyone can take it and claim it as theirs. But in that case, they are infringing my freedom of creating and having ownership, property ownership of that, and also giving it out as it is with the coherence and the expression that I had. So, or I could say I want to give it out to everyone, but not for profit. So I want to attach to that the idea that I want this to circulate as much as possible, but I don't want anybody else to profit out of this. Or I could attach some ethical, and that's where solidarity economy comes in, that it's not just freeing, making something freely available, but it's making it freely available for the common good. And if that can be used in a destructive way, then for me, it shouldn't be distributed. So I want we're talking about intangible products, but it could be also tangible products. I want this to be used and reproduced by someone else. I free its design. We work on product designs. I give the whole design out, and if you have a 3D printer and it's a product that you can reproduce, you can do it. But if you do it to harm another person, then I will not allow you to do it. And in that, I keep the property, the relationship with me. So it's a bit more complex than saying, okay, we intend property as a commons or not. There's always an attachment. You define the attachment.
But also the means of production is even more complicated.
What's the means of production?
Yeah, this solidarity system.
It's the people who work together in the enterprise. So since these are self-managed enterprises, mainly cooperatives, but not only cooperatives, they're in different forms. In a cooperative, the workers are also the owners. And therefore, they own also the means of production. But it's a collective ownership. There's not one of them that owns the means of production and that gives them concession to the others.
So you connect the social model with the cooperative idea?
Yeah, where it works. But there, for instance, in agriculture, there are a lot of small family producers in the Brazilian definition of solidarity economy. They are not classified in the backward solidarity economy, for instance. Because, well, you can explain that, but in other places they are. So it really depends. They have to fulfill some basic criteria: non-exploitation, environmental sustainability, and things like that. If they work in that sense, then and they're recognized by the Solidarity Fund network, then they are a Solidarity Foundation.
And what about all this experimenting in Rosaba?
Experimenting?
All this experiment that's happening in Rosaba, in Kurdistan, in Syria, it's quite close to the idea you're saying, I think.
I have read something, but not enough, and have no direct knowledge to say yes, I agree or not, but it has many communitarian forms that look like.
Yeah, I mean, not only about economy, but also
governance forum,
yeah.
And said yes.
You mentioned something about licensing right before, commons licenses, public domain, and things like that. Some of us participate at the digital liberation movement, at the free software movement, and the last 2-3 years we're deeply concerned about free software licenses and commons licenses. Because the things were all right till some years before, but it seems that these licenses do not guarantee a safe route that the work done will come back mainly to the common. So an artist, for example, may release his or her work under a free license, and this license may safeguard that the work will remain free. Others can build up or use or reuse or copy and distribute and all these nice things, this work. But there is nothing in this license that can guarantee that a profit made through this work, or a part of the profit made of this work, and if there is some economic profit.